Hello students, welcome back to the class. We are going for the next topic. Previous classes we have studied about M.M. Punchi Commission. We are continuing the same topic. Okay, so previous classes we have discussed about appointment of governor, president rule we have discussed, appointment of chief minister we have discussed, all Indian service we have discussed, and fiscal relations we have discussed in the previous class. This is so these 5 points we have discussed in the previous classes. So M.M. Punchi Commission, already we have discussed that this was a commission which was set up under the leadership of Justice Punchi, and that's why Justice Madan Punchi, and that's why this commission is called as M.M. Punchi Commission. This commission was set up in 2007. What we have discussed in the last class, that this commission was set up and they have prepared the report, and this commission have presented its report to Government of India in 2010, and they made some following recommendation. So first, they have made a recommendation. The aim is cooperative federalism, okay, where the powers are distributed equally, and where the central and state government should cooperate. So in the last classes we have discussed about appointment of governor, we have discussed about president rule, we have discussed about appointment of chief minister, how it should be appointed, that should be appointed from the leader of majority party, okay, and in case of hung parliament, whatever the provisions which are there in constitution, according to that that should follow. President rule should be imposed only in rare circumstances, only in emergency conditions. When president rule is imposed, that should be taken into considerations regarding the interest of state also, okay, directly should not be implemented. The areas which are quietly disturbed, in that particular areas only the president rule should be imposed, okay, and this will affect the development for others also. Appointment of governor, so governor should be appointed, what we have discussed in the previous classes, that governor should be appointed, okay. He should be the eligible person. Whatever the recommendation which was suggested by Sarkaria Commission, M.M. Punchi Commission also said same thing, that whatever the recommendation which was made by Sarkaria Commission, that commission should be followed, okay, and all Indian service should be set up in 3-tier, and they should have proper integration so they can able to discharge the service, and they have a good financial relations between central and state government. So central and state government should have a good fiscal relations between them. Next one, 6th one, point C, cooperative federalism. In cooperative federalism, the commission have presented its report. What the commission have presented, that in all the sectors, the central government and state government must cooperate. So to provide welfare of the people, okay, when we are coming about the welfare of the people, they should have proper cooperative between the central and state, okay, there should be a proper cooperation between central and state government regarding development. The main aim of every government is to provide welfare activities. Welfare activities, on the other hand, development activities. So while providing the welfare activities and development activities, they should have proper cooperative federalism. Cooperative federalism means central and state governments must properly cooperate among themselves. So whenever the central and state governments are making proper coordination, and when the central and state governments are implementing the plan, so central and state government should implement proper plan. So when they are cooperating for implementing the plan, then only the particular society or the country will develop. So we have discussed also, again it was written, so they should have proper cooperative federalism. So central government, when they are implementing their policies, that policies to implement in the state level, state government should effectively cooperate with the central government by implementing their policies in the state level. So what will happen, central and state government, when they are coordinating and they are working properly, then that leads for the development of country also. Country also will develop well. So it that will start from central government only or implementing any schemes. If the state government will operate and they will follow the schemes in that particular area, then there will be a great development. On the other hand, if you see interstate councils, this commission have presented that certain amendments should be made. Interstate is nothing but connection of different countries. Connecting different countries is called as interstate. Central state means the relations between central and state government. Interstate means the relations between the different state, that is called as interstate. So here the commission has suggested and the commission has made some proper amendment. in this amendment, what they have made, they should have proper relations between the different states, and also they should have a good relation between central and state. Okay, so in interstate councils, the commission have made some amendments should be made, that they should have proper amendment in interstate as well as central state. Okay, changes. Amendment is nothing but changes must be made by interstate council. So interstate council, what are the changes should be made? The changes must be made in interstate, and also the changes must be made in central state. Next we'll go forward. Now constitution governance is the governance which are following the constitution. Okay, in whatever the government which is following the constitution, that is called constitutional governance. Now this commission, they have suggested that central government should consult with the state government when they are implementing any legislative policy. The central government should consult with the state government for implementing the concurrent list. We have already discussed earlier that lists are of mainly three types. One is called, we have discussed in the earlier classes, central list. We have discussed about state list, and we have discussed about concurrent list. In central list, we have discussed that only the central government have right to make the law which are on central list. So totally 98 lists are there, like atomic energy, defense energy, railways, okay, or minerals we can find, and many other sectors where the central government have right to make the law. So that list comes under the central list. But in concurrent list, already we know that state and central government can able to make the list, that is concurrent list. So whenever the concurrent lists are imposed, both central and state government should be cooperate, because this list are issued by both central and state government. So whenever the concurrent list is imposed, both central and state government must cooperate. So here central government should consult with state government. So whenever there are issuing the concurrent list, both the central and state government must cooperate properly, and they should implement or they should issue the list. Now this commission had broad agreement, and this commission have introduced different type of bills. So this commission should introduce different type. This commission have recommended that they have to introduce different type of bills. So whenever the central and state government cooperate, then only they can able to introduce some bills regarding concurrent list. Okay, so this commission have favored that in terms of concurrent list, both central and state government must cooperate properly. If both central and state government will cooperate, then only the concurrent list and introduction of bills can able to possible. If any central and state level, if they will cooperate, then only they can able to introduce some bills. Okay, new introduction of bills can be possible. So that is one point. Next one, local self-government and decentralization. Decentralized means whenever if you are distributing the power should be distributed equally. Distributing the powers at lower level. Whenever the powers are distributed at lower level, that is called as decentralization. Decentralized. So local self-government means the government which are appointed in self area, local area. So that is called local self-government. So whenever the governments are set up in the local area, that is local self-government. And on the other hand, we see in decentralizations. Decentralization means decreasing of power, that is called as decentralizations. So this commission has favored that another commission should be appointed, and that commission should submit the reports regarding local self-government. So this Punji commission have made a recommendation, that MM Punji commission, what they have made a recommendation, that one more new commission should be appointed, and that commission should be appointed, and that new commission should prepare a report about local self-government and devolution of power. Devolution of power means whenever the powers are distributed at lower level. Whenever the powers are transferred to the lower level, that is called as devolution of power. So this commission, so local self-government and decentralized, so this commission, what they have favored, that the commission have favored that there should be one more commission should be appointed, and that commission should prepare a report. Okay, that new commission should prepare a report about local self-government and about devolution of power, transfer of power. Okay, that is one point. Now last point, this is about socio-economic development. So this commission have prepared what the MM Punji commission have prepared a report, that this commission have suggested that there should be a civil society. If they wanted a good government, they should have a civil society. Okay, civil society means what? What is called civil society? Civil society is nothing but children. This is the mainly society which is quite different from government. Okay, this is the third section of society. We can also call it as second section of society. Central government is first, state government is second. So if you see civil society, this is the third section of society, and this is quite different from government, and this will mainly work for the welfare of the people. Okay, and this is quite different from government, so this is non-government organization. Civil society is a non-government organization mainly to provide welfare or to any other development activity. Civil societies can able to play a very important role. So this commission have suggested that there should be some civil society for good government. Whenever the good government, if they wanted to have a good government in the particular area, so civil society should be established. And this civil society is independent from government. This is quite independent from government. There is no relations. Okay, and they have independent from government. This is quite different from government. So such types of society should be established, and that society can able to lead good government at local level also. So that is called transfer. Okay, that is called as socio-economic development. So what this commission have suggested a report last socio-economic development. This commission have suggested a report that whenever there are transferring the power, so some society should be set up. Civil based society should be set up. So this civil based society, what they will do? This is a non-government organization. This is a third sector of government, and this sectors can lead the development for the society. That is called a civil based society. So overall, children, MM Punji Commission have made the following 9 recommendation we are studying here. First recommendation, we have discussed about appointment of governor. Second recommendation, in this how the governor should be appointed, we have discussed. He should be the eminent. He should not be from the active politicians. He should be appointed from other state and should be given 5 years. Then we have discussed about president rule should not be imposed. Only the disturbed area, whatever the areas which are disturbed, there only the president rule should be imposed. Appointment of chief minister. So here if you see how the chief minister should be appointed from the leader of majority party. And we have discussed all Indian service, okay, should be set up at 3 level, and they should have integrated system. Fiscal and financial relations should be strong. Okay, finance commission have set up. So this commission, so central commission will provide income to the state commission, and state finance commissions will provide income to the backward areas to develop. So whenever the state government need funds, the central government should provide funds for the development of weaker section or for any other development activity or welfare activity. Cooperative federalism means, we have discussed, central and state government must make a proper cooperation at different level. So here welfare, and if you wanted development and welfare activities, proper cooperation should be there in between central and state government. Coordination and cooperation is very important for implementing and making our policy successfully. And then we have discussed interstate councils. In interstate council, we have discussed the commission have made proper amendment. In this, what they have made amendment, that interstates, they should make some changes in interstates and central state. Interstates means relations between the different state, and central states means relations between the central and state. And then we have discussed about constitutional government. So constitutional government, in the sense the government which have the constitution. So here the commission have preferred that in terms of concurrent list. Already we have seen the central list, state list. In terms of concurrent list, both central and state government must make proper cooperation for implementing any policy. If central and state government wanted to introduce any new bill, so they should have proper coordination and proper cooperation, and they should discuss on the issue of concurrent list. Decisions are important, because this is the concurrent list where decisions of both central and state government is very, very important. Next, local self government and decentralization means what? Self government, which are set up in local area, and decentralization means transferring of power or distribution of power. So this commission have suggested that one more new commission should be appointed. So that should see the that should prepare a report about local self government, and new commission will prepare about the transfer, how the power should be transferred. Okay, at last we have discussed about socio-economic development. So to have a good government, if you wanted to develop the good society, so we should set up the civil society. Civil society is the third section of society, third sector of society, that is quite independent from government. It is very independent from government. and this society is a non-government organization also, we can say. So such types of society should be implemented in the area, local area, so that can also lead for good government children. So these are the commission children which was recommended by MN Punji Commission. So we'll meet you in the next class tomorrow. Thank you very much.